Have you ever felt the curse? With your whole being, the pox upon life itself, feared and despised by all. The reviled blessing. Apparently not. You are but a lamb, a stranger to defilement, ignorant of your own ignorance. You no longer interest me. I've been long without peace. Don't spoil my quietude. I asked you not to disturb me. Be thankful of the whole serenity. It is all that keeps your death and defilement at bay. I asked you not be thankful of that. It is all that.
Greetings. Are you here for spirit? I need to warn you about something. A little while ago, someone started lurking in the wing on the opposite side of the round table. And I can hear, from all the way over there, the howling and wailing of spirits in fear of a curse. I can even hear the repulsive twisted malice in itself. A plethora of spirits in an unceasing cacophony. I can't even imagine how much suffering inflicted to who knows how many souls. Not even the grafting caused anything like this to happen. You should keep your distance. I know you're strong, but please, I can hear it from across the wing, past the howling and wailing of You should keep your distance. I know you're strong.
I am pleased to see you. Would you like me to... You are so very warm. My dear, might I ask something of you? Could you please find the owner of this dagger and return it to them? A certain person gave it to me as a gift. It's a very precious thing. It must have a special place in the owner's heart. So I would like for the original owner to have it back, if you wouldn't mind. Dear Roger likes to talk of it when abed. The ancient plot, in which the first of the demigods, the black knives wielded by the assassins who, along with the impressions they made, somehow, I'd like you to find the owner of the dagger I gave you and return it to them. It's a very precious thing. It must have a special place in the owner's heart. Then good day to you, my dear.
Ah, you. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I...
I asked you not to be thankful of that. It is all. Greetings, my... I take it you've heard of the Eternal City of Noxtella? Well, it has a twin, known as Nokron. The other Eternal City. After years of expeditions, we've determined the location of Nokron by going underground through the well in the Mistwood of Limgrave. You can see Nokron up above, only we've failed to find a path leading to the city. Blythe's made a good go of it, but I'm afraid this has him quite stumped. To be honest, I'm not sure where to go from here. Blythe is Lady Rani's stepbrother. Rani's mother, Queen Renala, approved of him, and they played like siblings from childhood. They were always happy to have me tag along as well. When Lady Rani renounced her flesh and chose the dark path of the Empyrean, Blythe and I swore allegiance as vassals. But none of us will ever forget our earliest days together. Promise to look after Blythe for me, will you? The man is honest to a fault. But fortunately, now he has you.
You again? I don't want any trouble. Be on your way then.